So swing spans, so just kind of play with your swing a little bit. And notice that the fabric is hanging from two carabiners. We're hooked up to daisy chains. So we're going to make sure it's not all twisted or anything like that. And we also have hand poles and leg loops. So everything's attached and they're installed with eye gloves. It's strong enough to hold 500 pounds, so we're all in good shape. And then we want to stretch the swing down to our hips to get a sense, and Mark, you might want to lower yours, you'll see. Yeah. Well, we'll see when we go into the
Okay.
Yeah. So.
I'm
sorry. It's okay. As long as you're having fun, you're doing it right. So we're going to come into plank pose, let our elbows and our wrists and our shoulders stack on top of one another. So we're keeping our arms straight. We're just going to pull our left elbow towards our knee, do a little side stretch. We're not going to touch, but we're going in that direction, right elbow to right knee. And switch sides. So go back and forth a few times. Just let yourself rock forward and back, bringing the elbow to the knee. And now we're going to try our leapfrog where we bring both elbows, both knees to both elbows, right? So just swing forward and back a few times. Nice. Now you notice if you pull yourself forward and try to hold, it becomes more challenging. So that would be more of a strengthening move. And if we want to just play, yep, you go forward and back. You have a perfect mark, I'm so glad. just there. Awesome. Really nice, guys. Okay, come back to our first position. So from here, we're going to change it up a little bit. We're going to hook our feet outside in. So keep the knees bent a lot. So remember, Catherine, just lengthen through the body. Yeah, just do one at a time. Yeah, lean forward and then keep up. Good. You got it.
Okay.
So hook your right foot a little bit better. There you go.
Yeah.
Perfect. Now from here, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to pull forward, and then we're going to press back. So pull forward, and then press back. So when we press back, I call this an upside down dog. When we pull forward, we're moving into a handstand, right? So just practice. Moving forward and back, keep your knees bent towards your belly. Bring your knees down, so Claire. Claire, pull your knees down, yeah. So what we're gonna do is make sure we keep that anchor point in our hips. If you bring your legs up too high, as you just saw, the swing slides out, and then we do a face plant. So it's just a little bit better to keep the swing nice and secure around our hips by keeping our knees bent. Okay? So we're in an upside down dog. Let's practice some chaturangas. So shoulders directly over our hands, and just bend your elbows. Bend your elbows and dip. Now, these are really easy chaturangas, right? Let's try to walk our hands back underneath our shoulders a little bit more so we're more in a handstand. And then you notice these are a little bit stronger, right? So this is how we can make our handstand, our chaturangas more challenging. We walk them forward and they're easy. We walk them back and they're harder. So just try doing five wherever you like. They don't have to be any big deal. Just make sure that you're enjoying that experience of strengthening your arms, preparing for some of the other more dynamic poses. Awesome. Really good. So walk your hands forward again. We're going to bring just the right leg down. Keep the left leg hooked. So we're doing a one-legged down dog. Then if you want to press the leg straight, we're going to start to walk our right foot forward into some standing splits. So in the standing splits, only go as far as it feels comfortable for today. See if you can bend your elbows and drop your head down towards the ground. But keep your right foot grounded. Keep your right foot moving forward. Good. So with the swing, we're going to go so much deeper into the poses. So if you want to clasp your hands between your neck and pull down, and give you even more space in the vertebrae. If you want to do the most advanced version, clasp your hands behind your back, under your sacrum, and then pull your hands over the back of your head. You have to get some good balance for this one. Nice. You might get a little swagger happen when you can stay balanced. That's great. Hands back down to the ground. Awesome. Now let's try swinging out to the side. Okay, I'm going to plant. Move this forward. Get my right hand down, twist up to my left. Straighten over leg. That's great, Mark. Okay, if you can reach for the outer edge of the swing, so right side of the swing, not left side. Keep going. On the other side. Yeah. All the way, yes. And then reach up as high as you can. We come into a big twist. Really nice.
So Catherine, we're going to turn our toes out to the side. Just watch the wall. We can kind of get past the wall and open up a little further. So going that way. Yep. Good. Yep, just keep going. Keep going. There you go. Keep going. It opens up. Keep going.
Oh, I see what
you mean. Keep going. Yes. Now you have some space. Drop your head towards the ground. Stretch out the side of the neck. So you're just my neck always gets a really good adjustment here. If I just drop my head. Good. I'm up on my fingertips. I'm reaching up high. Nicely. Thank you. So we're slowly just going to slide back through center. Both hands down. Take a pause. Bend the knee. Just let that foot find you down the up. That was a nice big stretch. So we're going to pause in the middle and make sure we take time to integrate whatever changes the body has had. Check out your head. Take a nice deep cleansing breath. Just relax. This will be kind of our restorative pose. Down dog becomes very relaxing after doing some of the nighttime movements. Let's inhale, come forward. Exhale, hook right foot this time. So pull yourself forward to hook your foot. Good. Hi-ya. Karate kick it. Awesome. So what we're going to do is straighten the right leg up. And then we're going to walk our left foot in. Come into a version of standing splits. Just come as far as it feels good for today. Hang up here. Take a few breaths. Bend your elbows. So you're dropping the crown of the head towards the mat. Towards the ground. Just let that stretch happen. Now clasp your hands behind your head and pull straight down if you want to lengthen through the vertebrae. If you want to go to the deeper expression, we're going to clasp our hands behind our back and then pull your arms overhead. Thanks. Of course, this is definitely an advanced move, so keep your hands on the ground if you prefer. Slowly release, come down, center your left hand, reach up with your right, twist. Catherine, you might want to straighten your leg a little bit more, the top leg. Yeah, and then when you twist, you'll have a little bit more stability. Great, so turn your toes out to the left. Your body will swing out to your Ardha Chandrasana. So you can slide out even more. Just keep going. Yeah, exactly. There we go. And now our bellies are facing the center of the room. Great. Drop your head, stretch the side of your neck. Let it feel good. Take your time. Slowly return back to center. Bend the knee. Release back down. Let's walk forward into a wide straddle. Okay? So we're going to add on to the sequence. Let's just pause here. Just notice that you found a sweet spot in your hips. There's one spot that just feels better than the others. Just hold on to your ankles and then pull your chin into your chest. Stretch the back body. Great. So we're going to walk forward into angel wings. Okay? So keep tension in the swing, just walk forward and come up. Nice. There you go, go ahead and use the walk. All right, so grab the swing and hang up here. Just take a little pause. I'm going to show you the next sequence and then we're going to do it together. Okay? Just because this is new, we're going to take our time with it. So we're going to come from our Ardha Chandrasana and then come up into some floating poses and flying poses, okay? Hook, twist. So I'm going to come out to the side. I'm going to reach up with my hand hold. Okay? So this is going to be step one. This might be as far as you go. You can bend the bottom leg and come into, this is phase one of the black swan. From there, what we're going to do is we're going to roll our belly towards the ground.